Welcome to the latest work of mental model series from Safal Niveshak. Daniel Kahneman, in his book Thinking Fast and Slow, recounts a story when he was invited to speak to a group of flight instructors. These guys told him that praising the pilots on their recent good performance usually resulted in a poorer performance and vice versa. Now, this logic was clearly against the conventional motivation theory that encouragement leads to improved performance. Actually, the flight instructors were getting fooled by an effect called mean reversion. It's a mental model from the field of statistics, and it states that an event which is not average will be followed by an event that is closer to the average. So if you flip a coin 10 times, typically the ratio of heads and tails would be 50-50, right? But it's also possible to have a set of 10 tosses where the ratio is maybe 70-30. But such event is way above average, which means if you do another set of 10 tosses, the ratio has a very high probability of going closer to 50-50 again. And that is called as mean reversion or regression to the mean. And all random events show this typical bell curve, which is also called as normal distribution. Flight instructors did not know that a poor performance followed by a better performance was just because of mean reversion. Now, the lesson is that when you see extremely good or bad results, they are unlikely to continue that way. But it's very important to remember that mean reversion happens only in the presence of randomness or luck. For that matter, the outcome of any event is determined by a combination of skill and luck. For example, some sports like swimming or chess, the outcome is purely a result of skill, whereas in gambling or flipping a coin, the outcome is totally dependent on luck. What about investing? Although both skill and luck affect the results in investing, luck plays a significant role, which means you can expect that mean reversion has a strong implications in investing. Many mutual fund investors choose their funds based on past few years' performance, but soon after investing, they find their fund starts underperforming the benchmark. Frustration follows, and then they pull out their money and find another fund manager based on the same criteria, that is, last few years' performance. And the story repeats. Because of mean reversion in stock market, periods of above average performance are usually followed by a below average return, and periods of below average performance are typically followed by above average returns, which means a bull market would be followed by a bear market and vice versa. Which means an investor needs to find those funds where the performance is a result of fund manager skill and not just luck or randomness. Question is, how do you separate skill from luck? The first trick is to focus on the process rather than the outcome, which means choose the fund managers who follow a sound and rational investing process and are not bothered about short-term performance variation. The second trick to minimize the effect of mean reversion is to take a bigger sample size. In other words, you should not rely on short-term performance records. If you're looking at 10 years performance figures of a fund, then odds are very high that the fluctuations introduced by randomness have evened out over long term, and what you see is a reasonable proxy for fund manager skill. What's true for a fund manager also holds true for a business. An investor should look for those businesses which are run by management who have long term orientation and those who follow a sound process. If you found this video useful, you may want to subscribe to Safal Niveshak's newsletter. Safal Niveshak. Value investing made simple.